The second debt limit meeting between U.S. President Joe Biden and top congressional leaders has been postponed to next week. The two sides initially planned to convene again on Friday, that's May 12, after their meeting on Tuesday ended with no breakthroughs. The U.S. is now facing a looming catastrophic default if it cannot raise the government's $31.4 trillion debt ceiling. The U.S. Treasury also warns without a deal, the U.S. will run out of cash by June 1st. Meanwhile, House Speaker Kevin McCarthy says the delay should not be taken negatively.
It's not a delay. I think from numerous different things. One, couldn't be there tomorrow. I don't think there's enough progress for the leaders to get back together. I don't know having certain ones in the room that's even productive. I think just as I sat down with the president February 1st, look, we want to be responsible, we want to be sensible. He ignored us now for 100 days. He thought this problem would go away like the border. We didn't want to sit back just like with the border, so we went to work and we raised the debt ceiling. Because we're the only people that can guarantee that we won't hit default because we've raised it. The Senate has done nothing.
Mexico border, where migrants are waiting the end of a COVID-era border rule. Thousands of migrants are hoping to enter the U.S. as the Title 42 policy ends at midnight Eastern Time. But the Biden administration has said the policy, which blocked the entry of migrants since 2020, will be replaced with new, tough rules. Washington's Homeland Security Secretary also warned those who will illegally cross the border will be quickly turned away. U.S. authorities have expelled migrants at the U.S.-Mexico border more than 2.8 million times under the pandemic-era policy. The Philippines is the world's third-largest plastic waste contributor, but as Rafael Busano tells us, efforts to raise awareness on the impacts of single-use plastics are paying off as more and more consumers are going green.
More consumers are going green as awareness spreads about the ill effects of plastic pollution on the environment. Recycling is one way of minimizing plastic waste, and many shoppers can be seen bringing their own bags.
Wet market, hay nako. Isang isda lang nabibili mo, tatlong plastic ang ibibigay sa'yo. Ang ano, plastic, walang pakialam, madami. Pero yung iba, ano na, educated na sila na, parang na-edukasyon na sila, taga minimize nila.
A 2021 study published by Science Advances reveals that the Philippines is a top contributor of river and plastics in oceans at over 356,000 metric tons. The Pasig River is also said to be the most polluting river. Results of the study are not hard to prove. As a matter of fact, this creek right here, whether in the middle or on both sides, is littered with plastic, which was once used as packaging for different products. One of the solutions the Philippine Department of Environment and Natural Resources sees is the Expanded Producer Responsibility Act of 2022, which requires manufacturers to be more responsible by limiting the use of non-environment-friendly materials.
Ito, binibigyan natin ang responsibility ng mga producers to help get rid of this waste.
But aside from using eco-friendly packaging, producers must also participate in measures to help reduce waste.
We've lightweighted our packaging, no? Hinigsaan namin, pinaliit. Kung manonotice nyo yung mga produkto sa merkado na yun, mas maliliit na because we want to reduce our utilization of virgin plastics. RTD drink, yun, naka-paper straw na siya, hindi na siya plastic.
The DENR admits a lot of challenges remain, especially for a country used to the so-called sachet economy, or products offered in single-use packets at low prices. But Environment Secretary Tony Yulo Loizaga believes problems caused by plastic pollution can be addressed.
The biggest challenge is in education and in changing the behaviors of people. And at the end of the day, that's what will determine the success of the EPR law. Just to look at the way your products, whatever you purchase, are packaged. Is that whatever you actually purchase needs to be packaged in a way that can be sustainably managed as a waste product.
Ultimately, a collective approach is needed to reverse the effects of plastic waste to the environment. Producers should continue to innovate and find more sustainable packaging, while consumers also need to be more eco-conscious in buying products while reusing or recycling goods. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Remaining Filipinos in Sudan decry the slow process of repatriation efforts. Danilo Aguilar, a Filipino worker waiting to be rescued in Port Sudan, shares over 130 have been waiting there for up to 2 weeks now. He says they are struggling with inadequate food supplies and accommodation. He adds 37 Filipinos submitted their names to Jeddah Consulate for rescue, but only 11 individuals, which did not include any Filipino, were picked to board the plane.
Opo, lahat po na nandito, nakapag-submit na po ng requirements. Yung 37 po yan, kasama po ako doon sa 37 na sinasabi nila. At last day po ay nandun po kami sa airport, which is naging chance passenger nga lang din po kami doon ng airlines. So hindi po kami nakapasok lahat doon dahil lang 11 lang po yung kinuha ng airlines na yon nung araw na yon. At sa 37 po ng Pilipino na yon, ay nag-back out po yung 10 doon. Bakit po? Dahil na dismaya na po sa ano namin eh, sa ating embassy. Out na sila, hindi na sila magpa-repatriate. So, naggumawa po kami ng ulit ng bagong lista at nagkaroon ginawa na po namin ulit na 37. Ang inihiling ko lang sa embassy natin na sana bilisan nila para ang lahat ng Pilipino dito ay makaalis na.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department vows to act urgently to rescue the remaining OFWs in Port Sudan.
Pangako ko po, papaabot ko ngayon ulit kay Ambassador Consul General kay Gary Ampilian doon sa Jeddah. Okay po? So, yun lang po. Pero alam namin, may nag-back out tapos pinalitan. Pero pagkaintindi namin yung 37, may tickets eh. So, bibilisan namin yung iba kasi lagpas 100 pa pagkatapos ninyo. So, alam namin,
yes,
may presyo, pero gagastusin po namin yan.